Hi, I'm Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. I'm also a TechSmith Camtasia recommended trainer here in the UK. This year, Camtasia 2018 was released, and I'm going to show you five advanced features that can really help to make your screen capture videos much more professional. Let's get started. Now, whenever I do any training with organizations, they often say to me, Russell, we want to have an interesting introduction before the screen videos or the screencasts start to play. So I've got some screencasts here on the screen, and I'm going to bring in the first three. So I'm going to just drag in three onto the timeline. So we've got some screencasts here, as you can see, and if I click on the button, we can play them.
Understanding, and then obviously.
And if we move on, we can see now straight away, one thing that I would notice about these screencasts is that the cursor is really, at the moment, it's just it's not very visible. So the first thing I would probably do is to come down here, click on cursor effects, make sure you've got all the videos selected and drop the cursor onto the video. So immediately you get a cursor effect. And what I normally do with that cursor effect, if you look over here on the right hand side, you've got your properties. I normally set that cursor effect to about an opacity of about sort of 50%, just so that yes, you can see it, but also you can see what's underneath. So straight away, bringing a cursor effect on will have an impact. Now, what I said to you is we're going to try to look at a professional start to these videos. Now, one of the things we can do, again, we're going to select all three videos, is we're going to group them together because it's going to make them much easier to move around. Now they just become one object. And coming up to the library here at the top of the screen, I'm going to choose Camtasia 2018, and I'm going to look for intros. So I click on the intros, and I'm going to use one that I really like a lot, and I use quite a lot, which is the spinning computer. I'm going to drag that onto the stage, onto the timeline, sorry, not the stage, and then bring back this grouped object. And now you'll see that we played a video, and it starts with a kind of really nice opening here. On comes the screen, unfortunately it says the wrong thing, so I'm going to change that in a minute, and then afterwards the screen capture videos
really
would
like
start.
The way that
so let's just go back a minute and see if we can sort out how do we deal with the problem that the text. So just play the video a little bit. When this video is played, just when the text comes on, just double click on that. You always know when you're right because it kind of goes a grey colour, and I'm going to change that for my company. So I'm going to write teacher training videos. Okay, so immediately now I've got a nice professional start to my video. Though one problem is, of course, at the moment is we haven't got any sound. So the next thing I'll be looking at is to add some sound to this video to make it really more professional. Now there's a couple of really clever things that we can do here to have some introductory music to go along with that animation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the timeline. I'm zooming in on the timeline so I can see it a bit closer. Now I need to bring some music on here. So again, choosing the library, Camtasia 2018. This time, just going to close that down. So we're not interested now in intros. We're going to come down to the music tracks. Now I can just click on the music track to check it. Not that one. Not that one. Yeah, that sounds a bit more lively. So I'm going to have this track. So I'm going to drag this onto the timeline. And you'll notice immediately it adds a new track as soon as I try to drag on. So now when the animation starts, oh, this is starting to look really professional, but there's a big problem. If we just move this screen to make it smaller so that you can have a little look at the timeline here, you'll notice that one problem is that the music goes on right into the animation when the screencast talks. Now, we don't want that. We want, as soon as the animation finishes, the music to finish. So I'm just going to play that. And then just there, in fact, what I can do is use this little button here just to go back to the exact point. It will move me back. In fact, that one moves me back, jumps me back to the last break. So that's a good button to click on. And at this point here, selecting the music, I'm going to click on it and cut it there. So I use this cut one, cut out, and then delete that. Select it and delete it. So the music is only on now until the actual, or my voice starts. So let's just check that. Now, the only problem with that is at the moment is that the music cuts out really quickly. And this is where I'm going to show you another great effects advanced feature in Camtasia. Come down to audio effects and drop on fade out. Just drop it onto that sound. You'll notice you get this kind of little point here that you can drag along. You don't want it to start fading too early because it's only a short animation. Now we've got something really professional. Let's just play that back. Music fades.
I really like the way that...
And speaking starts. Yeah, I really like this. It's starting to look a little bit more professional. So now we've got a nice intro. We've got a cursor effect on the screen. Now, what else could we do to make this even more interesting? Well, one of the things that I've noticed about this is, and there's a little trick that we can do here. This video is one size, and this screen is actually another size. And so... if you notice that this video has got some boxes around it. So one thing, in fact, there's two ways that we can do this. I'm going to show you the first way. We could simply just make that a little bit bigger and take a chance that it's still going to look okay. Now, I'm slightly worried about that because worried that if it gets too big, the computer's almost going to come outside. And you still notice we've got a little area here that's not being covered. We might be able to position it about right. So in fact, this looks like we can possibly just expand that one screen or one video so that it fits nicely onto the screen. Let's just test that and see if that works. So looks like it's going to be okay. And that looks fine because this is obviously the actual area that's going to be produced. All right, what you're looking at there is the actual canvas area. Right, so what else could we do to this video to make it a little bit more interesting? Well, the next thing that I would suggest is that we have a transition, so we move from the opening to the first video. So selecting, and in fact I'm going to now ungroup all of these because I'm going to ungroup. I'm going to narrow down, so I'm going to move right out now so I can see a lot more of the animation. And now what I'm going to do is select all of the animations. So notice I've selected all of them. I'm going to come up here to transitions, and I'm going to add in a nice transition. One that I use a lot is called cube rotation. I'm going to drag that onto the screen. So I've added the cube rotation at every point. Now that might be a problem, and we'll just check this in a minute. So let's start. Now, I don't like the cube rotation there on the first one. Remember, I've dropped it onto all of them. So I'm just going to maximize and just come in. I'm going to just click on that first cube rotation and just delete that first one. I don't want a cube rotation at the beginning. So now I've got the animation taking place and that all looks fine and the words come on. But let's watch what happens now. Lovely. So it cube rotates from the introduction into the next video. And let's just quickly have a move along the timeline and just check the next one. Because I selected all the videos, then in fact, the cube rotation was dropped on all of them. So let's have a quick check here.
The learning content.
Yeah, so the first love thing it. We'll need okay, to... looking really nice. So this is kind of working well. And I've got my different... animations now on the screen. So what we've done so far, well, we've added sound, we've added an opening animation, we've added a cursor, we've added a kind of cube rotation to create a little bit of animation with it. Now the other thing that I would suggest here is that you'd probably want to have some kind of ending. So let's go right to the end of the video. We're going to come back up to the library now, and again we've got lots of outros. We can use an intro as an outro, it really doesn't make any difference. I'm just going to click here. So we've got outros anyway, so let's have a quick look at our outros. They don't look particularly interesting, so I'm going to come to our intros and I'm going to see if there's any here that might look quite nice. Well, this one here, let's have a quick look here. I'm just going to drag that on and I'm going to do obviously the same thing. Probably I'm going to add the music. Let's just play that outro.
Yeah, and then the students now simply need to start accessing the Kahoot.
Okay, so what I might do here then is just simply add something like thank you. Okay, so I can just delete what's on the screen. I'm just going to write thank you into the screen. So what I've quickly done there to save time is just simply clicked on the text and rewritten it. Now in this particular case that text is too big. There's various things you can do here. Remember, with any object you've got on the screen, you can always click on it and check here on the right hand side, are you happy with the colors, etc. So for example, let's imagine I wanted to change the text color. I could click on that text color and change it to a different color. Let's say for example, put it at that color there. And I can of course resize the text as well, so clicking on that text and I could also make sure that it's a smaller size because I want it to fit inside. And the same with this one here, I'm going to make that a little bit smaller. Okay, and I'm also going to change the color. I'm going to click here and choose the same color as the... Okay, so now we've got a video with an ending. And of course, what I would probably do is add the music to the end as well, just like I did at the beginning there. Have the music on, cut the end off, and then fade it out. Let's just have a quick look.
As a group. So I'm going to choose classic. I click here.
So I just play the end part.
To start accessing the Kahoot.
Okay, and then we got our ending, goodbye. Okay, very good, looking really nice, very professional. As I said, I would add some music on there. I've showed you how to do an intro, I've showed you how to do an outro, I've showed you how to add music, I've showed you how to add a cursor, and I've showed you also very quickly how you can just quickly resize the screen if you need to make sure that the videos fit within the canvas. I've showed you how you can make use of the properties. I really hope that you found that useful. I'll probably end up showing you more than 5 features there, but hopefully you can get how you can use Camtasia to take your video to another level. Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. I really hope you found those videos useful. Please come to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots more content available. There's a special section called Camtasia. You can see it at the top of the screen there. Lots of videos showing you things about Camtasia 2018. And just click on any of the videos that you want to watch. And of course, I suggest that you watch them full screen. When the videos come up, just click and watch them full screen. If you want to sign up to the newsletter, you can always sign up to the newsletter on the right hand side. You can keep up with the latest videos that I've uploaded. You can keep up with any short courses I'm running, any webinars I'm running, and occasionally I have special offers also on software. You can also make use of all the free content that's on the website. Particularly popular is Russell's top 12 videos. And there's a special section on the front page. If you come onto the front page and look at the special sections, if you're interested in any particular topic like the flipped classroom, theory, there's even a section of very quick videos, 5-minute videos. Finally, if you really want to follow me, then please join me on Facebook and on YouTube. And if you've liked this video, please leave some comments. And if you've got suggestions for other videos in Camtasia that you'd like me to do, please post them underneath and I'll try and produce some more videos for you. Thank you very much.